Welcome to Earl Stewart on Cars.
Every product sold has got a very specific cost. New cars don't have a specific cost. It's a convoluted mishmash of holdbacks, kickbacks, rebates, and incentive money. The best advice I can give anyone that is trying to figure the cost of the car is to forget about it. You're never going to know the true cost of the car. It is interesting how this cost is so complex. Most of you have heard of holdbacks. Holdbacks are kickbacks that the dealer gets back at the end of the month, sometimes quarterly, sometimes every 30 days, used to be once a year. And the manufacturer packs profit into the invoice that he pays to the manufacturer. When I buy cars from Toyota, I get an invoice for the car. And I get a new Toyota Camry in with a certain amount of equipment, and they send me an invoice. It might be for $19,500, let's say. Now, about a month later, I get thousands of dollars back from Toyota. And the same is true with Honda and with General Motors products and with Chrysler and Ford products. All dealers get these kickbacks from the manufacturer. The invoice in any other business, in any line of manufacture, retail, whatever, an invoice is the cost. Invoice means cost. You get an invoice from the Florida Power and Light, you pay the invoice. That's the cost of your power for that month. You get an invoice from Bloomingdale's for a television set you bought. That's the cost. That's what you have to pay. What the dealer pays the manufacturer is not his cost. It's his cost inclusive of a lot of profit they get back. They also rebate other things. There's secret dealer incentive money that is kicked back to the dealer that you don't know about. Now, there's what they call dealer cash. You don't hear about that. And there's customer cash. You hear about that. There's also something called floor plan assistance. Floor plan, for most of you who don't know, is the cost of financing the car on the lot. A typical dealer might have several $1 million worth of new cars on his lot available for sale. Well, he doesn't pay for that out of his pocket cash. He finances those cars, and he borrows the money from the bank. The manufacturers reimburse him for the cost of having those cars on his lot. They call it floor plan assistance, and they kick that money back to him, too. There are rebates that you've never heard of before, so you may never know the cost of the car. Now, you can go to certain internet sources like Edmunds.com. That's a good, very good source of information, EDMUNDS.com, or KellyBlueBook.com, KBB.com. You can even go to Consumer Reports. Oftentimes, they'll give you the dealer invoice, but that's not the cost. And they might even endeavor to try to tell you what the real cost is with holdbacks, but they don't know all the holdbacks because they change monthly, weekly sometimes. And so even the dealers actually make mistake on what their cost is because they don't fully understand the cost of the car. And instead of trying to figure out, I want to buy a Chevrolet, so what is the cost of that new Chevrolet? Don't go there. Don't try to figure that out. The best consistent thing that you can use to compare apples and apples and measure your deal, your discount, what sort of a bargain you're getting on the car you want to buy, is the MSRP. Manufacturer's suggested retail price. Why? Because it's mandated by federal law that every new car must have a Monroney label on the window. So if you're looking at a new Impala 2013, and you look at that at Schumacher Chevrolet, and you look at that at Roger Dean Chevrolet, and you look at that at Del Rey Chevrolet, that Chevrolet Impala with the same MSRP will have the same cost. Compare apples and apples. Get the exact same MSRP, and then shop and compare. Competition is your strongest tool to getting a good deal. When Schumacher finds out that you're going to Roger Dean Chevrolet and you're going to get a price on that exact same Impala, that 2013 model, with the exact same accessories and the exact same MSRP, he's going to come down and give you eventually his lowest price. Roger Dean will do the same thing. And then you can go to Del Rey Chevrolet, and then you can go to Miami Chevrolet or whatever the other dealers you want to go to. And that is the best way to get a price.
Let's go.
Earl Stewart.